Hey guys, welcome to this short video of Assembly 64. This is meant to be an instruction for how to use the tool and get the most out of it. So let's begin. This tool runs on Windows 64, 32, it runs on OS X, and it runs on Linux. You can find the download location and location to the project in the links down below. So we start by logging in. If you're not registered, you can do so here by clicking this link. Otherwise, we log in. So this is the main screen. I start by selecting a location for where I want my content to be downloaded. I click cancel here for now. So here we see a list of available collections. All the ones with this red dot, they are not installed, but available. And this one is available, but it's actually out of date, since I do updates of the content every second or the third week. You will then be able to start assembly, select your same location, and just update the content, which I will demonstrate here. So I click update, and it just fetches the delta of what you have installed and what is available. And so here we see it turned green, which means we are up to date for this one. So I continue. I want to download this, I think. It's Demos Top 200 from CSDB. So we click run in background, and I can click on, I can take another one, games. So here we see downloaded and downloading. Now we're done. When we're done, we can choose open folder, and we can click the content and run it. I have Vice installed, so I can run it on my MacBook. Should work fine, apparently. Really nice demo, but we shut it down for now and continue. As I said, these artifacts can be downloaded to your hard drive, or you can simply select, when you select location, you can choose your micro SD card or USB stick if you use a product like 1541 Ultimate 2 or something like that. Then it's really easy to keep your USB stick up to date. But we continue. There are a few other things that I want to show you here. I go into settings. I choose Vice binary path. I need to specify that. And I select the binary and click OK. Then I can go into this, I call it like search and stream tool. It's if you don't want to download entire collections, you can search for your content and just download it and run it instantly instead. So here I try to search for Horizon, and I find a really nice old demo called Bounty Hunter. So I double click and I get a view. This is from CSDB. And I see the files, and I double click the files, and I open up a D64 browser. So I can see here, I can run it since I have specified the Vice binary. So this is quite nice. All right, we shut this down. And we shut the monitor down, and we shut this down. I could also download to install base. That would mean that I download files to the folder I specified, so I can run it like this if I wanted to. But we shut down. And of course, you can search on name, you can search for group, you can search for handle event, rating, yada yada. You can also search for different, you can unclick these ones to make your hits more specific if you search for like SIDS or anything like that. You can also click on only latest content. That is the same as I described before. That only displays the content that was recently added. Yeah, I think we're done here. I close this down. I'm going to show you a bit of CDFI also. This is an experiment I did, which was quite fun. I wanted to have like a music client where I can create playlists and download music and stream music. So I created this tool here. I'll just try to delete this one for now. So what I can do here is I can search for a group. I can search for this guy. So I get all his songs. I can click. And yeah, when I find an entry like this, it actually means all those songs are aggregated since this is his entire collection. So I can add to a new playlist and I create Fiddle House. And it appears here. And then I can just... And obviously this comes from High Voltage Seed Collections. And there is a lot of nice music there. This is another list I've done of my favorite music. Plan is to, when I get some time, I will do a public playlist here so we can listen to each other's playlist if we want to. But that we have to see when that happens. Yeah, I think that's basically it. Yeah, you can view log, change log, instructions. Yeah, I have instructions here also, but I think they will be removed. Backers of the project and stuff like that. This is what I wanted to show you. Thank you for watching. Bye.